So here we are. We are now rolling, and this is Jerry Yamamoto's middle service today on 19 August 2021 here at Pacific Crest in the Redondo Beach area, and a wonderful turnout so far. There'll be a little period here before this starts.
Thank you. if you want to take a seat, please find it. I am fully vaccinated, and I'm going to practice social distancing, but to help
can't
to be heard.
You.
Can't hear you. Let's get in.
Can't hear you.
In order to be better heard, I'm going to take my mask off. I'm fully vaccinated, and I'll practice social distancing. Let us look to the Lord for the invocation. We are gathered here to pay a lasting tribute and respect to our departed comrade, Jerry Yamamoto. We extend these final earthly tributes to him. O God, giver of all life, please accept our prayers on Jerry's behalf. Welcome him to peace in your presence. Look with mercy upon his loved ones bereaved by his passing. Comfort and console all of us in your kindness and tenderness. These things we humbly ask in your name. Amen. At this time, we'll have the military honors.
Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow soldier and I are here to render final military honors to a fallen comrade. Military honors will consist of a play of taps, unfolding, refolding, and presentation of the flag. During the play of taps, the civilian hand salute is the right hand over the heart. For any current or prior service member, please render the proper hand salute. At this time, if you're physically able to stand for the play of taps, please stand. May be seated. United States Army and this grateful nation. Please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your loved ones' honorable and faithful service.
Is Jim Maddox present? At this time, Jamie would... At this time, Jamie would like to share a poem in honor of her father.
Took the strength of a mountain, the majesty of a tree, the warmth of a summer sun, the calm of a quiet sea, the generous soul of nature, the comforting arm of night, the wisdom of the ages, the power of the eagle's flight, the joy of a morning and spring, the faith of a mustard seed, the patience of eternity, the depth of a family need. Then God combined these qualities when there was nothing more to add. He knew his masterpiece was complete, and so he called it Dad.
Thank you. Is Jim Maddox present? Yeah, please come forward and share with us Jerry's personal history.
Real close?
Yeah.
Sorry I'm late. I'm a guy who still has a BlackBerry and gets printed out directions, so no, I don't use directions, and it trussed me up magnificently. My name is Jim Maddox, and I knew Jerry for about 20 years, and one of the things I have here for him is a achievement medal from Vietnam Veterans of America, and it's for outstanding service the Vietnam veterans and their families, and it was presented to Jerry, well, for Jamie. Can we say something?
Do you have more personal history?
Okay. Jerry and I go back about 20 years. He ran into someone probably 15 years ago and said, I ran into this Vietnam veteran, but I didn't know, he can't remember his name, but he's a black guy. And immediately Jerry said, did he have a jacket on? Yes, that's Jim Maddox. I'm Jim Maddox.
To share personal remembrances of Jerry, I'd like to call Jean Kuniyoshi.
Hope you can hear me. I have two hearing aids. I heard maybe 50% of what's been said so far this morning. I was married to Jean, one of Jerry's sisters. Jean loved her brother. Took him to ball games when they were both young. Visited him at Washington State with my mother-in-law, supported him when he went on an archaeological dig in Washington. He played golf, tennis, and he bowled some too. He flew an airplane, tail number November 1940 Yankee. He actually owned it for a while. He made it on TV on May 28, 2009. He appeared on a panel of Vietnam veterans on C-SPAN. The episode was moderated by Vince Okamoto and included David Miyoshi from the SCY, plus three others who I didn't know. Jerry did a great job on his part of that panel. He was instrumental in having Vietnam memorial signs installed on California highways. You may see memorial signs on the freeways touting the Vietnam veterans. Those signs are the result of Jerry's and the committee's hard work and persistence to get the legislature to agree to have them erected. One of the skills Jerry had was as a talker. He could expound on any subject anyone wished to bring up. That, coupled with the steel trap memory that is a hallmark of the Yamamoto clan, is what he brought to discussions, especially including the description of streets and highways of places he had been. Adventures with May and Jamie are replete with great detail as to the ambience of the places, the lay of the land, and street names. I think Jerry did his family a great service in taking them on various trips around the country. For me, the real Jerry, while accomplished and acknowledged for the serious things he did in life, also one who lived and enjoyed himself as much as possible. One of his and my friends, Roy Layton, who lives in Australia now, put it this way about Jerry. I'm thinking along the lines of the free-spirited guy who emerged out of the wilds of the rainforest of the Olympic Peninsula in his VW Combi bus, something around the early 70s. Incredible enthusiasm for just about anything, friendly as anything, laughing and up for anything. With his VW bus, he would go anywhere, anytime, offer you the shirt off his back, drop everything to help you out. He and May put me up for the night, late night notice. He says, sure, come around, you can stay over, no problem. Jerry was at all the SCY gatherings. That's the Southern California Young People's Christian Conference. And he arrived in his combi while everyone else was arriving in their modern cars. He excelled in tennis, winning tournaments. He and May had a pretty memorable trip to New Zealand about February 1981. Wrote me a very long letter, and it was dripping with enthusiasm and enjoyment of all the places they had been. Sheep shearing in New Zealand? Who would have guessed? But he was excited, and it was contagious. To me, his energy and vitality were amazing. I think May was expecting at the time. Maybe that's where Jamie got the bug for travel and visiting so many places and destinations. I got to say that Jerry was a prolific letter writer back then, and he wrote some of the longest letters known to mankind. I think maybe he never slept, or he could write and sleep at the same time. Roy. So for me, Jerry was just as described by Roy, was a great guy who worked hard, was tenacious in things he believed in, and tried his hardest to enjoy life every day. Rest in peace, brother.
Now we'd like to call up Paul Werner for sharing some memories.
Okay, can everybody hear me?
Yes.
I'm a Marine, you know, so I gotta like make sure everybody hears me now. Okay. Well, I've been in the Chapter 53 VBA for 26 years. And when I joined, Steve Miguel came in with me, and Jerry about a year later. So, Jerry joined our chapter around 1996. Within a year, sure enough, Jerry was elected president of our chapter, and for the next 20 years. So, and by what the guy, a true veteran, had his hands in everything that included all veterans. Well, I remember the VBA Chapter 53 had our garage sale at the American Legion on Camino Real in Redondo Beach, and Jerry and all members would bring out their products to sell by 8 o'clock. Of course, everybody was already there by 6, waiting for us to open up. And of course, Jerry would make sure that our products were all marked and priced. And of course, we had a 5-gallon water bottle for donations, and yes, he always had control of that water bottle and could count the money, and we all knew that. Now we couldn't forget about the Hermosa Beach Fiesta, Memorial Day and Labor Day. As a Chapter 53, we always had a booth open, and Jerry would bring down in his little cart all the sale of our products. And of course, at the end of the day, he would make sure he had control of that 5-gallon water bottle with all the money in it. He made sure he counted it himself. He would not let nobody touch it. Good guy, though. Yes, Jerry was a true veteran, and he did many things for all of us vets. And I think he didn't stop until he held it in. I'm proud to say, that you were our true veteran soldier, and you are one of a kind, and may we never forget you. And now you are helping and organizing more veterans in heaven. Thank you very much.
Offered his life as a service to our nation's cause. Proudly, we remember his service. Because of men and women like Jerry, we live in a land of freedom, peace, and justice. May this ceremony today deepen our reverence for our honored comrade and friend. Jerry was baptized, which is a symbol of the hope of resurrection and the life everlasting. We believe he is now in the hands of our Heavenly Father, the Supreme Commander and Judge of all. As we lay Jerry's ashes to rest, let us cherish his virtues and learn to imitate him. Let each of us be loyal and faithful to our remaining missions in life, that we too will be able to finish our time on earth with dignity and honor. We realize how futile mere words are to express our deep and abiding sympathy in our loss. May we be comforted by the assurance that our comrade, friend, and loved one is at rest in God's eternal peace and abides in a place where all burdens are lifted and there is no more sickness or pain. Friends, let us now pledge ourselves anew to provide support and protection for those left behind, to pick up the banner laid down by Jerry, and continue to march to face the challenges that confront us in this life. And may our God always be our companion and guide. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, we ask that you would look in mercy upon all of us here assembled with your compassion and tenderness. Console and comfort those bereaved by the hand of death. Bless us with your peace, we pray. Amen. For as much as the spirit of the departed has returned to God, who gave it, we therefore tenderly commit his ashes to their final resting place while we look forward to the resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come. Amen. We have a special tribute from the Vietnam Veterans of America. I will call those making the presentations by name and they will come up and present something on the table. First is Chapter 53 President Dennis Wilde, who is honoring Jerry's service in the Vietnam Veterans of America with a medallion.
Good morning. You can hear me? No?
Louder.
Good morning. You almost have the planet on your lips. Well, you know, I'm sure that Jerry has found comfort in the fact that they asked a Marine to start the final tribute. I'm sure he really appreciates that. And again, my name is Dennis Wilde. I'm president of VVA South Bay Chapter 53. And back in 2018, VVA celebrated their 40th anniversary in existence. And out of that 40 years, Jerry was our president for 20 years. And I must add that the last 11 years of his presidency was the best because I was his secretary. In 2018, the VVA celebrating their 40th anniversary, they did make this medallion, commemorative medallion. And Jerry, at his expense, tried to get every member in our chapter a coin. Right, Jamie? He went out of his way and we really did appreciate it. On the back of that coin is the VVA motto, where it says, never again will one generation of veterans abandon another. And I truly believe that Jerry dedicated his life to support that motto. I truly believe that. So Jerry, here's your commemorative coin. Rest in peace, brother.
VVA National honored Jerry with a posthumous medal for achievement. And Jim has given that to Jamie, but Jim Maddox, would you come forward and present the medal on the table by the ashes. Can you open the box so everyone can see the medal?
You want me back again? Jerry was my friend, but he could talk more than I could. My wife said, the only thing about you and Jerry is that you keep talking and talking and talking. The medal that I gave Jamie was from the national office of the board of directors of gave Jerry the achievement medal. Jerry was an outstanding supporter of veterans. One of the classics that I remember of Jerry is at our convention in New Orleans. He collared Senator Richard Blumenthal from Connecticut as he was leaving the auditorium. And Jerry started talking to him. And these two young assistants were trying to move the senator on. Jerry would not let up. And he talked to him and followed him around until the bank of elevators. And he set a pick. He was not going to let Richard Blumenthal on the elevator until he found out, he let him know the issues that affected veterans. The character piece of Jerry that demonstrates is he never talked about himself. He wanted to make sure that Richard Blumenthal knew that these are the issues important to veterans, and that was Jerry. He never talked about himself. He always talked about what's in it and what do you need to do for veterans. So the next time you see Richard Blumenthal on a talking head on MSNBC, NBC, wherever you see him, just remember, oh yeah, you know Jerry Yamamoto, don't you?
The man who succeeded Jerry's 20 years of being president of Chapter 53, Kirk Gillette, will present a gavel symbolizing Jerry's leadership in our chapter.
Jerry was a great friend and patriot. He inspired me. I was very happy to work for him. I was the guy with the pickup truck and the strong back. He was quite an inspiration to follow. And all of his adventures represented Chapter 53. It was my honor to work with him.
Honoring Jerry's patriotism, Steve Creasy will honor him with a little American flag.
Good morning, everyone. Jerry would have been happy about that train coming through. He wouldn't be so happy about this other work over here. Today I'm placing this American flag to represent Jerry's patriotism. Jerry made a choice. In his early life, he and his family were unjustly treated by the government, plain and simple. Jerry did not let that affect his love for this country, and he showed it by enlisting in the U.S. Army and later by his life's dedication to veterans. I can't think of a person with more patriotism than Jerry Yamamoto, and through the years it was a pleasure to work with him. He also did a favor for me. About the time he had joined the chapter, I was the president for a couple of years, and I had a son that was going to a military academy and needed a lot of time to be able to travel and support. Jerry ran for president, and we all voted him in, and we kept a good man in place for 20 years. Thank you.
One of Jerry's pet projects was to have a portion of the Pacific Coast Highway, California 1, designated as Vietnam Veteran Memorial Highway. To honor that project and Jerry's leadership in it, Steve Mandel will place a patch, a memorial patch, on the table. So, Steve. At this time, we'd like to offer opportunity for a floral tribute by everyone. We have flowers available if you can get one and place it on the table. But then come back to your positions. We'll have the benediction, and the family has some words to share with us. So please come forward, receive a flower, and honor Jerry. Thank you. tonight, let us bow for the benediction. Our gracious God, the author of life and of death, we turn to you in this hour of grief, knowing full well that we may find comfort and help in the time of need. Grant these sorrowing ones your richest blessings, that they may be strengthened and comforted. More and more may they take hold of your hand of helpfulness in faith and understanding. Guide us and sustain us as we share our sorrow together. Amen. I'd like to ask for the family representative.
Here. Is this better?
Just the mic.
Okay, I just wanted to share that the weekend after my dad passed, my friend was sitting in his backyard and he saw two butterflies land next to each other and he knew that my dad was okay and that he was with my mom. So, I'm just happy for everybody and all his friends and all the messages and love that we've received and received. At this time we won't be having a reception, but later when COVID gets better we'll have a full celebration of life that'll be a regular memorial and celebration, because I know my dad would love everybody to get together and drink and tell stories and just laugh and eat and everything. So thank you for coming.
This concludes our service. Thank you all.